Hi guys, thank you for joining me. Here's an update what's going on with the Yellowstone Supervolcano. Up by Livingston, Montana, there was a magnitude 4.1 earthquake. At 12:29 p.m. local time, I believe. And last time I counted, there was 29 buffalo roaming around here from the Old Faithful webcam, but more about that earthquake. It was a shallow earthquake, only about 3 miles below sea level, and all earthquakes are measured from sea level. 221 people sent in reports to USGS, two of them to EMSC. They gave it an intensity level of 3. Here we got Helena, Hall, it says there, Butte, Livingston, intensity level 4. Okay, another 4 from Livingston, another 4. Let's see, 4. Intensity level 4 means to the people there it felt like maybe a magnitude 2 or 3, excuse me, or a 3.5. Felt indoors by many, outdoors by a few. If they were sleeping, they would have been woken up. Dishes, windows, and doors were rattling. Autos rocked noticeably. But on EMSC from Livingston, it says lots of shaking, rumbling, and a loud boom. Whole house shook for about 2 to 3 seconds. Pretty wild. Yeah, it shook up Yellowstone Caldera. It is within the uplift of Yellowstone Caldera. And what's interesting about this earthquake is it shows uplift. Let me bring this down. I'm currently trying to download data. How do I know the ground rose up? Well, here's the moment tensor ball. We got spreading. Yep. Yep. So, yep. It only spread because the ground rose up. And the reason the ground rose up is that it is within the area, which I got drawn out with a black line of where the ground has risen because of Yellowstone supervolcano recharging and magma coming into the system. All right, so let's come down over here. Most of our talks and my reports are about Yellowstone. This is the lake. And this is the outside caldera rim where the magma is at. And if I bring it out, you can see. Let's bring it out a little bit farther. Past all my writing. Can you see this black line? Yeah, this volcano is so large that you could see it from space. Can you see that there? I got so many notes. Here's a live stream view. I got 4 that have connected. I'm still waiting on the Madison River area. This one here at the top, that is for the western boundary. Next is Denny Creek. The next is Maple Creek. And then down here at the bottom would be Soda Butte. Maple Creek and the western boundary are showing 2 aftershocks. USGS is only reporting 1. That would be a 1.4. And they got one before that, a 1.3. So I downloaded. Here we got the western boundary on the left, Maple Creek on the right. I only downloaded that section. And there's the earthquake signature, the seismic wave. And let's go to this one because it's got a better signature. Let's take a look at what we got here. All right, let's extract that. Yeah, long. Yeah, we got pointed ones also, which means the fault move. But the long, rounded ones are volcanic tremors. So this earthquake comes in as a magnitude 2.07. I'll bring it down for you. Right there, 2.07. And there's the seismic signature again. And then the second one, right there. Let's pull this up and we'll go to the spectrogram. Okay, again, better on Maple Creek. All right. 2233. They are reporting that one. Okay. I think they are reporting the other one now. They're saying that is a magnitude 1.2, but I get a 2.10. Yeah, we know they lie. And the other one they're saying is a 1.4. Boy, are they wrong. And they're saying it's way down here by Yellowstone Lake. The 1.4 up there by Madison River. But both of those are over a magnitude 2. Now look at the magma that came up and the hot gases and hot water. Holy cow. Yeah. Yeah, you're going to be shocked about this. I came up with a magnitude 5.24. That is a large one. Okay, let's go back over here. 5.24. Yeah, not no 4.1. Yeah, and I'll bring it over so you can see all the gases and, yeah, all the pockets of melt. Let's take a quick look at this here. Let me bring it over. It shows the hertz. Yeah. Okay, we'll go back over here. And let's go there. Oops, I got to bring this up to do that. Okay, let's extract that. See? Those of you that follow me, you know that is volcanic tremors. Magma coming up. Oh, look at that. Magma coming up in the system. That's why we got spreading. That's why we got spreading. Yeah. All right, let me pull that. Look at that. Long and narrow. Those are volcanic tremors. Volcanic tremors are usually only 3 miles down. And that's what this earthquake was. 3 miles down. Yep. I believe it was 2 days ago. I'm going to be posting that. But 2 days ago, when they zoomed in back here, this steam was extremely dark, which you know is because of the heated water coming up to the system, melting the rock, which is over 2,000 degrees Fahrenheit. Not too bad right now that it is a little dark. If they would zoom in, and I've talked about these areas where the ground is melting, the snow, the current temperature. Let's check out that. 8 below 0. And then you have the wind chill. That doesn't tell you what the wind chill is, but currently, let's see, the wind is blowing about 1 mile an hour. Okay, and then let's go back to temperature. It's going to be minus 23 degrees, so you should not have melted snow. So look for the video that I'll be posting next. I have to upload it and all that stuff, and it's going to take a little bit. But yeah. What'd I say? All right, so I want to get this out to you as quickly as possible. All these interruptions. You guys, please stay safe. Always be prepared. And it's never too late to stop, to start preparing for any type of disaster. Please. Yeah, at least it would beat inflation, or if you lost your job, you know, you'd have something stocked up. You know, you go and buy whatever you need for that day shopping. Instead of getting one, get two. And then when you go shopping again, leave that extra one off to the side and get two more of whatever. And then you slowly build up your stock. All right. Well, thank you again. Please stay safe, and I'll talk to you later. God bless you. Bye.